Today we are going to continue our test on the baloney fork. This time it's going on a bicycle, it's going down a trail, but first, we want to get redemption on the smasher. We built this fork smasher for precision testing of bike products and how much impact they can withstand in comparison to each other. But there were a couple of problems with this, and I think I've solved most of them. And so we're gonna give these forks another run and see which one bends the most. So of course the goal we have in mind is determining whether this cheap Amazon Air fork is as good as this Suntour fork. And so the first thing we're gonna do is test the Suntour fork by smashing it right here and seeing how much it bends, and then throw in the baloney fork from Amazon in and see how that goes. So yeah, we've got smashing to do. Okay, so three times, then we measure how much it bent. That was already way better. Three. Okay, that test went way better than the first round before the improvements. Let's see how much this thing deformed. Whoa, that's a lot. Okay, so total deformation of 30 millimeters for the Suntour fork. So that's a lot more than the first time. Let's see how the baloney fork stands up against the tried and true cheap Suntour coil fork. This actually doesn't sound so good.
Seth, you should use a snatch block.
All right, baloney fork. Performed better than I thought. It looks like it's starting to bend pretty good, but not as much as I thought. All right, let's see how much it deformed. That's a healthy amount of deformation right there. Let's see how much it was exactly. It deformed less than the Suntour significantly. Let me make sure that my subtraction is right. Subtraction is hard. So we ran those numbers through the Berm Peak supercomputer and turns out I was right. This deformed 30 millimeters, this deformed 21 millimeters. So the baloney fork performed better in that test than the tried and true Suntour fork. Now, one thing we can also be certain of is that Suntour tested this fork too. Mass market fork could be that it's performing exactly how it's supposed to. It just keeps bending and bending and bending and meets an anticlimactic end, whereas this one stays strong up to a point and then snaps in half and you smash your face into your stem. So we don't really know which one is better overall. We just know that the Suntour bent more. Yeah, now you can see. Whew. Not only did the baloney fork perform better in the Berm Peak Smasher, but it's got air pressure, rebound damping, and it weighs 2.5 pounds less than the Suntour fork, all for $130 on Amazon. But does it perform better on a mountain bike trail? That's what we're about to find out. And so I've installed one on the Kent Trouvaille. I also upgraded the derailleur, as a lot of you suggested, to the one step higher micro shift that has a clutch. And so we're gonna take this down the same trail that we did last time, but first, I have to install these new labels on the fork to just make it more appropriate. I think we got the sizing just perfect. One thing I'm noticing right away, just pedaling, this thing is way lighter. We knew it was lighter, but I didn't think it would be something I'd really feel. It's pretty drastic, and it feels good. So if you're wondering why we are out here in the woods with a Walmart bike and a $130 Amazon Air fork, probably should watch the videos that preceded this, but If not, I'm gonna bring you up to speed real quick. We bought this Kent Trouvaille at Walmart for $400 because it looked really promising. We fixed all the problems that it had out of the box and then proceeded to put upgrades on it. Now we tried to make these upgrades as cost effective as possible, most bang for your buck, and so far we have changed out the brakes, we have changed out parts of the drivetrain, today we put a new derailleur on it, and we have this $130 baloney air fork. Coil forks are not bad, they're just not very flexible. So if you're 300 pounds or 90 pounds, you're riding the same fork, and this we can adjust the air pressure. Another thing about this fork is that it has rebound damping. That's gonna control how fast the fork returns to position, can help keep you planted on the trail. Now I've already broken this fork down, taken a look what's inside of it. We put it on the smasher and determined that it's pretty strong. I think it goes without saying that this is a brand new version of what we smashed, not the same one. But now it's time to see if all this culminates into a better trail experience. And so we're on the same rowdy trail that we tested the Kent Trouvaille on last time. We're gonna give it another go. Oh, no, forgot about this. Wow, okay. I honestly don't know what to say. This has been pretty uneventful. It's operating smoothly, it's quiet. I'm like worried about when I'm gonna find out why this fork is $130. It's worth noting that if you took any 120 millimeter hardtail down that, you'd be a little bit underbiked. This is pretty impressive for what it is. It really, really is. And I'm not even done with the trail. But something else to note, this fork has 20 millimeters more travel than the Suntour fork. So all things considered equal, it should feel a little bit better on this trail, and it does. But that's not all. Because it has 20 millimeters more travel, it actually changes the geometry of the bike to be a little bit better downhill. I believe we've changed the head tube angle by an entire degree. That shouldn't be good for everything, but it should be good for going downhill. So I'm impressed. Derailleur performing fine. I don't hear the chain slapping around very much. Haven't dropped any yet. That's not a surprise. Let's finish up and get back to the shop. So we're back at the shop. I survived. The bike survived. Let's talk about what happened here. First of all, crank set. This was one of the best things we did to the bike. It held up perfectly, helps with chain retention, kills like three birds with one stone since the crank set and bottom bracket that this bike comes with are not that good. And so still very, very happy with it. The Zoom hydraulic disc brakes. These were also a major, major upgrade. I'm really happy that I put these on here because a descent like that, you are just cooked if you don't have the right brakes. And so I would definitely recommend getting some kind of hydraulic disc brake for this bike. Next, the derailleur. This was really by request. A lot of people in the comments wanted us to upgrade the derailleur. It's $60 for this. It's the same derailleur that the bike comes with, only has a clutch. So when the cage goes like this and slackens up the chain, this derailleur has a little switch over here, put some resistance on it to keep the chain on, and it works really well. We didn't drop one chain during that ride, and that was very, very rough. Now, another thing that happened on the last ride is the wheels fell out of whack. They were kind of wobbly, and I have since trued them up and put more tension on all the spokes. In this ride, the wheels did better. The back wheel doesn't have any wobble in it to speak of, and the front wheel, just a little bit, we'll have to line it up again, but that trail was way above this bike's pay grade. Now on to the baloney fork. I was pretty impressed with this. So, first of all, when we put it in the smasher, it did better than the Suntour fork. I broke this thing down and it didn't look that bad from the inside. And today on the trail, it definitely performed better than the coil fork that came on this bike. It had a little bit more travel and so it took bigger hits. It felt more responsive and it's better when the bike takes flight. So when you take off, because it's got rebound damping, it doesn't extend with such violence. It's much quieter. And then when you land, it helps you stick the landing better because it's got rebound damping. It's not bucking you off the bike. Overall, I was pretty impressed with it, except for one thing. Didn't feel as good at the end of the ride as it did at the beginning. I don't know if that was just in my head. Yeah, it just, it seems to have more stiction. Now that could be for a lot of reasons. For one, there might've been some dirt ingress. We might've scratched up some of the parts in there. Certainly looks like it. Might need to top it off with transmission fluid. Whoa. It could just be wearing out after that ride. That was a lot of abuse. Now, one thing I can tell you about those Suntour forks is you could leave the bike in the backyard for about 10 years, clean it up and just use that fork. This one, I would guess, degrades pretty heavily over time if you don't really stay on top of it. And that's really worrying. It performed great in all of our tests, but once we really took it out on the trail, one trail ride, the performance kind of degraded. So in anticipation of this happening, I bought what I think is a better fork than this for a little bit more money. This is $190. It's an air fork. It has compression damping. It has rebound damping. And it's made by good old SR Suntour. Now, like I said, it's 190 bucks. If I had not destroyed the original fork, I could have traded it in to Suntour for a discount. And the build quality is vastly better than that baloney fork. And honestly, I think this one's going on there. Much better for the money. To be clear, that fork doesn't seem unsafe. I think you could put it on a kid's bike. You're not beating on it as hard as I was today, and it's gonna be more or less okay. It's probably gonna be better than what came on it. But yeah, we need better for the Kent Trouvaille. I think this is gonna be the answer. So if you wanna follow along with future Kent upgrade videos, we're probably gonna start getting out of hand with this thing. Subscribe to Burn Peak Express. And you may have noticed the shirt I'm wearing. This is a snake pit shirt. This is a feature we have back there in Burn Peak. And we made a metal themed shirt for fall. And you can see there's snakes crawling out of it. There's an old full face helmet with a skull still in it. This shirt is metal. And so if you're interested, I put a link to it below, cognitivemtb.com. We have it in a hoodie, long sleeve, whatever you want. Thanks for riding with me today. And I'll see you next time.